I came here about 4 months ago from Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, and I was very relieved to get here. The biggest difference in coming here was that there were no bars on the windows, and there was no restraints, and there wasn't any locked doors. There were rules to follow, and you were on an honor system and trusted. The staff trusts you a lot, and by their trust, you learn to trust them, and you can work out a lot of problems you have.
Staff Sergeant Thomas K. Sutton, it is my duty as military judge to inform you that this court sentences you to be discharged from the service with a bad conduct discharge.
What have I gotten myself into?
Find it hard labor.
What am I going to do now?
To forfeit $367 of your pay per month for 6 months and to be reduced to the grade of E1.
Court-martialed offender can lose everything. A promising Air Force career is gone. And life in an Air Force prison is not pleasant. The crimes are serious. The punishment can be devastating.
Jail. Never thought I'd be here. All the hard work and time it took to make those stripes. Another gun. For making one stupid mistake.
But for a select few who show a potential for rehabilitation, the Air Force offers a second chance.
I'm Lieutenant Colonel Shelby N. Cordon, the commander of the 3320th Correctional Rehabilitation Squadron. We have Air Force prisoners at Fort Leavenworth, Fort Riley, and the Lowry Confinement Facility.
The mission of the 3320th is to provide and conduct a rehabilitation program whereby selected prisoners can have the chance to upgrade their discharge or to even continue in the Air Force and make it a career.
I have some good news for you. Your clemency evaluation officer has recommended you for entry into the 3320th Correction and Rehabilitation Program. As it looks now, you're to be traveling next Thursday, unescorted, to Lowry Air Force Base. You'll report directly into the 3320th.
The schedule is tough. They're up at a later than 5 o'clock in the morning. I go to evening formation, and then it's during the week, lights off at 10 o'clock. Each individual starts out at a one privilege level. We have a privilege level system that is designed to give additional privileges as they proceed through the program and show that they have the responsibility to accept these privileges.
Being in confinement gave me a lot of time to reflect on who and what I am as a person.
Individual and group counseling sessions are important parts of the rehabilitation process. Rehabilitees are encouraged to discuss their feelings about themselves and others.
How can I just be myself in groups of people?
Maybe you can use this group to learn to get in touch better with your feelings and express them here in this group. Then once you're able to be in touch with them and express them here, you can do that on the outside as well. And this will help improve your relationships with other people so that you can do that clearly with them and understand yourself as well.
So how's he doing an individual?
Well, individually, he seems to be doing quite well. He appears to be getting a lot of meaningful insight into his issues and is sincere about resolving his problems.
The goal of the 3320th is to return quality people to the mainstream of Air Force life with a better understanding of themselves and the productive role that they have in today's Air Force.
Had a definite, positive effect on the success of the wing and the base mission. The distinctive accomplishments of Airman Sutton reflect credit upon himself and the United States Air Force.
My advice to anyone who is messing around and taking chances is not to, because you won't always be as lucky as I am or the people here are. We've all been given a second chance. There are a lot of others who won't get that chance.